Hi all, I'm Professor Anup Matthew. I used to get a lot of questions from many parents as well as the engineering aspirant students regarding the course as well as the branch selection of engineering. They usually have two questions. One is which college, second question is which branch. So today we are going to discuss about how you can select a college or a branch effectively by keeping the students' interest as the primary thing. Welcome to the video. We know that in addition to the seasons, there in the summer, winter and monsoon, in India we have an additional season that's called admission season. In this season, one gets attractive advertisements from various colleges imparting professional education. Since long, engineering has been the most preferred and usually almost all the advertisers or the engineering college used to say that's a rest assured choice for professional career. It has been proved that engineers are generally highly versatile when it comes to identifying employment. We have seen engineers getting into multifarious career ventures like creating a milk revolution, telecom revolution, or maybe becoming a politician or an author, obviously a cricketer or film actor or even as a magician. Examples are many in front of us. So getting an engineering degree was once upon a time like a dream achievement. So today, it is no more a lucrative profession to pursue. The story beyond engineering college is not very encouraging nowadays because jobs don't come automatically to the fresh pass out engineers. There are 100 plus varieties of engineering branches and sub branches available in the prospectus if you just go through it. So deciding upon the right engineering branch, that's a bit tricky, especially for students or the parents. It's like medicines. Every composition has some value and is helpful to cure some or other illness. But this happens only when the doctor reads the symptoms rightly and prescribes the right medicine, right? Likewise, all engineering branches lead to success. What is required is to have the right match. The need is to choose the branch as per the interest, aptitude and ability to the student. The biggest dilemma for a parent or a student is whether we should look for the college or for the branch. This is a question generally comes to any parent's mind. My take on this is both are important. Branch as well as the college, and you have to be really fortunate to be the one to get both. My personal opinion is you have to give weightage to the institution first, since any course in a good premier institution may help you to fetch a very good job without much hassles. Getting the first job always does matter. After that, your career will be most probably decided by your performance on job. But still, the students to first weigh the options available for them and research the credentials of the institute thoroughly. Go through the college and affiliated university websites and ensure the basics of accreditation, facilities, faculties and the quality as well as the qualifications of the faculty, etc. etc. You can even make a call to the college and ask about these data. Never hesitate to do so. You have every right to ask for these details. Also, you can review the past performance of the institute in terms of placements, teaching faculty, results, or the infrastructure. Most of the time, the results that you can get, the results means the credible results that you can get from the affiliated college website, affiliated university website. But still, you have to keep it in mind that every student, every aspirant, every engineering aspirant should stick on your interests. Many children get compelled either by the parents or by the peers. That means there are 11th or 12th standard classmates to select some particular branch of engineering or to some college. All such students should take into cognizance the fact that future scope would be worthwhile only when you have the desired aptitude to work in a particular field. Sachin Tendulkar may not be a good engineer if you would have chosen as a mechanical engineering graduate. He made his footprint in cricket because that was his passion. Similarly, you have to think about your passion before you choose the engineering branch, not the college. You have to keep one thing in your mind that every branch of engineering generally brings about a decent set of job opportunities as well as career prospects. However, if you end up selecting a branch only on the basis of pre-assumed job prospects, irrespective of your interests, that might not lead you to anywhere. Yes, this is the most important thing. You should look beyond the 4 years of engineering graduation program. Engineering degree is not the end of the journey for most of the students. It's the beginning of your career. Many students prepare for post-graduation either in engineering or administration or management. It would be wise to plan for future and assess the options for higher education or how to get coaching for, that means coaching for GATE, etc., etc., all those things in that particular city where the college is situated. Also, students should try to understand the life after graduation thoroughly. Every branch of engineering terminates into a specific job role. Or we can say that every branch of engineering converges to a specific job role. Before selecting a branch of engineering, students should try to meet as many engineering professionals as possible and understand their lifestyles and career prospects. For example, if you feel that you will not be entertained with night shifts, then there is no point of going and taking a graduation in instrumentation engineering or mechanical engineering. So think twice about the job prospects as well as the nature of job before you opt for any specific branch. This is also very important. Many parents as well as the students, they used to get confused with this question, whether you have to opt for a specific branch or a super specialty branch. To make things clear, the students as well as the parents may be a bit confused whether we have to select a mechatronics branch or mechanical engineering branch. Similarly, IT or computer science. These kind of questions will come to every parent's mind as well as the engineering aspirant's mind when they search the options for branch as well as college selection. You have to keep one thing in your mind that the job search options will be much wider if you select a specific broader branch like mechanical engineering instead of you choose mechatronics. Because mechatronics is a specialty branch that generally deals with the concepts of mechanical engineering as well as electronics, generally on robotics domain. But especially in public sector companies or government companies or even private companies also, they hardly mention anything called mechatronics or mention any of these super speciality specializations. So majority of the time, it will be always better you to take a broader subject. Why I'm telling this is the job opening of a mechatronics engineer that will suit for a mechanical engineer also. So he can apply for that post also, but the reverse may not be possible. Now let's discuss the plan of action to finalize a college or a branch, how to select it. First, you have to form a list of colleges that you prefer. So list of best colleges sometimes help in framing the final decision. This is the first thing that you have to do. Also, if a candidate already knows the stream, some students, they may be very much streamlined towards a specific branch. In that case, things are a bit more easier. In that case, you need not think about the branch, but you just think about the college. After you list down this list of colleges, you please list the branches that are offered by that particular colleges. This can be done in a Excel sheet also. That makes things much easier. But if you are not familiar with Excel or any of these spreadsheets, you can use a pen and paper. Please note that the list should be purely based on the interest of the candidate for the subject. After that, you can shortlist the colleges as per the streams. So in this time, candidates will have to mark the colleges providing the stream of his or her choice. Next is probably one of the most important thing, that's a weightage that you are going to give for the location of the college. Even after making the list of colleges and streams or branches, one has to emphasize on the location of the colleges that you have shortlisted. The location should be feasible for the candidate and the family to pay visit from time to time. As a parent, you have to keep that thing also in your mind, because if the college is far away from you, too far away from you, you may not be able to visit them. Even the mandatory PTA meetings also, you may not be able to come over there. Even in case of exigencies also, you sometimes feel a bit difficult to reach there. So make sure that the location is somewhat accessible to you. Another point you have to consider is the fee of the college. If the college belongs to a government or a government-aided college, fee may not be an issue. Rest of the cases, you have to make sure that the fee is affordable to you, though the options of loans are available. But make sure that the fee will not be the concern of selection. Or in other words, the fee factor should not ultimately decide the branch or the college. Sometimes some colleges, they may offer you a heavy fee cut. But neither the college nor the course may not be good for the student's future. So fee, obviously you have to consider, but that should not overweigh the rest of the parameters. The important factor left is the faculty of the college. They play a vital and crucial role in framing the career of a candidate. If possible, try to gather information from the alumni of that college. Nowadays, it's very easy. You can search on the LinkedIn or in the Facebook, or at least try to find a single person on the Facebook or LinkedIn and send messages or requests. Try to get connections to them and try to get the feedback. Most probably, most of these alumni, they used to give sincere feedback. At least you can sample from many sources and collide together, because it's your ward who are going to spend over there for the next 4 years. Quality of faculty, attitude of the faculty, that does matter a lot in grooming up an engineer successfully. The bottom line of all discussion is all branches of engineering have the potential to deliver a great future to your student. Selection of institute as well as the right branch, both matters a lot. Understand and analyze your aptitude, interests and skills, and apply these details to select the right branch of engineering. I hope you have enjoyed listening to this video. If you have any queries, any doubts, please put that in the comment box. See you in the next video. Till then, bye from Anup.
Please subscribe and click on the bell icon for more videos.